Hey YouTube, how's it going? You guys gonna have to pardon the appearance today. Been working all the morning. Went ahead and chopped down some trees, cleaned up a bunch of garbage. Got a burn pile going today. It's almost burned down now, but still burning out. Just been doing a bunch of cleanup today. Got the area of my porch set up where I'm gonna be setting up the exercise equipment. And that's what we're gonna go ahead and take a look at. I already unwrapped the bar right here. This is a cap bar. All this stuff was ordered off Amazon. It was the cheapest route I could find to go. The entire setup was around $650 shipped. This is the bench. Just an adjustable for incline bench. Does not have decline. Incline only. And then this is the rack below it that we'll be setting up. And then the weights are all sitting over here. I think there's four boxes of weights. The weights came with 300 pounds total. So there's 300 pounds total weight, bar, a bench, and a rack. So hopefully I'll be able to set it up today. I'll set it up on a tripod, set the camera up on a tripod, and I'll probably just like flash forward as I'm doing it, do it as kind of a time lapse. That way you guys can see it go together, and then in the end we'll take a look at it once it's done and see what it's like. I'm sure the quality on this stuff, like I said, this was the cheapest route that I could find to go. $650 shipped off Amazon. It's not high end. It's not going to be the best quality you've ever seen, but it's a way to get a home gym at your house for real quick. So let's go ahead and take a look as we go today. Don't know if you guys can see it right there or not, but this is bent and chipping. These are supposed to be flat. This is where the seat portion of the bench will get put on. As you can see, that's bent. So I'm gonna have to grab a hammer and straighten that out real quick. Okay, a couple quick taps with the hammer. I got it all straightened out. Did not scar the finish to hammer on it. Didn't mess anything up, so good to go. What the fuck? No extra parts? You mean I did it right? Alright guys, so this is what it is. It's got a handle on the front and wheels on the back, so you can just pick it up, transport it wherever you need it to go, move it, whatever. The seat portion on the bottom has adjustability, so you can adjust it to be tilted upward or down, flat, however you want it for whatever lift you're doing. And then it locks into the pre-made spaces. There's three different notches. And then the same with the top. You can adjust it out and it'll, oops, too far. Anyhow, it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 adjustments so that you can adjust your incline to what it is that you're looking for. It also has band spots, or if you're doing stuff with bands, you can hook your bands to these, like if you're going to do butterflies or bench press too, but the rack also has them. So if you were doing bench press, I'd use the ones on the rack. But all in all, not too shabby. Quick to put together. Not too bad. Next, the rack. Alright, had to move the camera in a little bit because it's kind of snowing out there. So had to move it in a little bit, but now it's time for the rack. Let's go ahead and take a look. All right. Just do a quick overview of all the pieces. This is the actual catch. So when you're benching or doing whatever, you get to set the bar on it. These are the catches. If you don't get your lift and need to let off, these are the catches that'll go at the bottom. Both of them have a rubberized surface on top, a harder plastic rubber on top of them. The upright supports, the supports that will hold it all together. And like I said, the rack has bands, positions you can put on there too. And then the bar is the pull-up bar. So this is stupid. I know it's a tool that comes with a kit and everything, but as you'll see on the end of this wrench, it's got this piece that sticks out right here. Well, when you're on a nut right up against the piece, you can't rotate it to tighten the nut. This is fucking stupid. So basically, this tool that they supply with it, you can't put it together with, because you cannot rotate this nut to tighten it, because this piece sticks out and hits the upright. So I'm gonna have to go grab an actual socket wrench to be able to put this part together. I have no idea why they put that on there. Get a close-up of this fucking stupid tool. So this piece here, why it's there, I have no idea. The nut is sitting right here, you put it on, you go to rotate, and you hit the upright, so you can't actually use it. Give you guys a comparison. Shitty tool, correct tool. But that's it. These are all adjustable, movable. Whatever you need to do, you're gonna come squat. You can move them up, put your bar on the squat position. If you're gonna bench or something, put them down here more on the bench. And then wherever you need your old overload bars, same thing. You can just move them to wherever your overload is. One of the things I noticed when I was looking through the manual for it is these posts on the back down here. What those are for is to put weights on. So if you need it to be more stable, if you're doing some kind of a exercise that pulls away from the strength of the rack, you could put weights on those two corners and make it be more secure, more stable. I guess I'll give it a test here. That's as good as the view gets, I guess. But I'm 239 pounds, 240 pounds with my gun and everything else on me. I'm probably 245, something like that. It's very stable. I have to swing pretty hard to get it to move. I'm hanging on it, no problem. Seems like it's gonna be pretty stable. Let me grab the bar. The bar fits in it good. There's room on each side of the bar, so you don't have to be perfect with your set down. Plenty of room to move the bench in on it. I mean, that's almost perfect to be able to get underneath the bar. Yeah, my overloads would have to go lower. I don't even have them on the same hole. Goes to show how far I pay attention. But that's gonna work great. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed taking a look at it and seeing what it's all about. I still have the weights to pop open. So I'll go grab them and we'll pop them open, throw them on, just take a look at them. See what kind of quality the weights are. In my opinion, weights are weights, but some people it's important. Let's look. Alright guys, let's take a look at what came in the four boxes like I showed you earlier of weights. We got 245, 235, 225s, 210s, 4.5s, and 2 2.5s. I believe that is 300. I don't know if the 300 is with the bar included or in just plates, but anyway, this is plenty enough for me to start off, just getting started with my strength and stuff. So I don't need to have a ton of weight. I just need weight to get started. The bar clips that come with it are extremely cheap looking. I'm sure they'll work, but don't look for nothing fancy if you're looking at those. But that's pretty much it, guys. Like I said at the beginning, $650, shipped off Amazon, bar, bench, rack, weights. You can do pull-ups on it. Of course, you could do squat, deadlift, bench, incline bench. So many things. Military press. You can use bands on it. Not only can you use bands off the rack, you can also use bands off just the bench. If you were pulling the bench out and you were doing flies or something, you could add extra resistance bands to it. The bench is adjustable to do inclines. You can do incline benches, incline flies, all that kind of stuff. I'm pretty happy with it. For the price I paid and the options I had to be able to work out and do it easily and cheaply, I'm happy with it. Hope you guys enjoyed. Have a little view of the Icelandic tundra that is Oregon in January. Alright guys, talk to you later. Bye.